This is my podcast. This is my podcast. Leroy Furious. The Leroy Furicast. This is my podcast. This is my podcast. This is my. I say what the fuck I want, bitch.
A single soul. Not a single soul asks for it, but Leroy Furicast episode 38 is here. Yeah. I lost like 10 minutes of the beginning of the podcast, so I'm just going to talk for 10 minutes right now to replace it, but I was outside recording again my podcast like I usually do, and I lost the first 10 minutes of it because I record on an old Android phone, and I just tried to transfer the video file, and it didn't work because, you know, it's an old Android phone. So I recorded the whole video, and I tried to transfer it. It got lost in the translation, like this one shouldn't be, but it got lost in the translation. Of me transferring it. Transformation? Transition? Whatever. It got lost. So 10 minutes is gone. I don't remember what I talked about because I was talking in the middle of the traffic. Like a busy intersection with wind blowing and the winter going on. Because it's very cold right now. It's November. What's today? November 18th. Yesterday was November 17th when I tried to record it. But I lost it. But I don't remember what I talked about. I know that I dissed a bunch of directors that diss superhero movies. Like Alejandro Gonzalez Inarritu, Denis Villeneuve. Fucking, yeah. Not even from America. Dissing American superhero movies. And American superhero movies, like these American superhero movies, they all fucking employ people from your countries. They employ people from all over the world. Like, they employ foreigners. And these two foreign directors dissing superhero movies. Like, how much money have you put into pockets with your shitty fucking movies? Not as much as Marvel and DC. I tell you that much. I tell you, you're not feeding families the way Marvel and DC is feeding families. You're probably feeding some people, but you ain't feeding a lot of people. Marvel and DC feeding a lot of people. A lot of people are eating good over Marvel and DC movies. Visual effects artists, special effects artists, everybody. And the nerve of these fucking directors to diss these movies, right? Denis Villeneuve, you can't diss superhero movies. I don't know if he did or not. I'm just, like, I'm dissing him anyway because Dune was trash. All you got is Sicario. All you got is Sicario. That's your movie, Sicario. If you ain't got Sicario, you ain't got shit. Denis Villeneuve, your movies is trash. Blade Runner 2049 was good, but I wouldn't see it twice in theaters. I see Sicario twice in theaters, but like Denis Villeneuve, you can't talk shit, bro. You ain't got the track record to talk shit. I saw Dune. It's a movie about Sam. It's not good. Dune is a background movie. It's not a good movie. It's a good background movie. If I got company over, I click play. And that's about it. Denis Villeneuve, stop it. You're not like that. You don't have it. You do not have the gift like you think you got. You're not who you think you are. You may think you are who you think you are because you're fucking European, but Denis Villeneuve, you are not that guy. Baby Keem is better than you. I read about a Baby Keem video than Dune ever again. Like, Dune is trash. I don't need to watch it. It's a trash movie. There's no point in watching Dune. Stay home. Don't even watch it on streaming. It's not good. You know? Old was good. M. Night Shyamalan, Old, that's a good movie. M. Night Shyamalan could talk shit. Because he made the Unbreakable trilogy. He made a great superhero trilogy. Denis Villeneuve never made a superhero trilogy like that. Ridley Scott never made a superhero trilogy like that. Alejandro Gonzalez and Inarritu never made a superhero trilogy like that. All these old people. I know Bill Maher did superhero movies, even though he's in Iron Man 3. So you get in the bag, but you hate the shit. You're still getting paid from it, so shut the fuck up, Bill Maher. Go fuck a 22-year-old. Have fun. Live your life. Don't worry about Thor, Love, and Thunder. Cause we checking for Thor, Love, and Thunder. Ain't nobody checking for Bill Maher's next special. No one. I guarantee you no one's checking for it. It's going to probably do some good ticket box office numbers, but anybody watching that shit? You ain't shaking the curb. You ain't moving nothing. You ain't moving the planet. Eternals moved the planet. Endgame moved the planet. Like, shit's moving planets. Like, you ain't moving no planets, bro. I'm not either, but I ain't dissing superhero movies. I ain't dissing nobody. I'm just responding to people that diss superhero movies. Like, you ain't that dude. I know you think you are because you got the complexion, but you're not. You're not that guy. You're not that guy. You're the guy that says house nigga. Like, that's who you are. You're the guy who says the N-word. Because, hey, what can I say? A new rule. I can say the N-word if I want to. Because they make superhero movies. Oh, shut up, dummy. I'm watching Doctor Strange right now. I'm not watching Real Time with Bill Maher. But I am watching Doctor Strange right now. Live from my parents' home. How you like that? Bill Maher. Talking all that shit. Who else the other guy to talk shit? Oh, Scorsese with the Irishman? Fuck the Irishman. He's fucking trash. Irishman fucking sucked. Endgame was good. Endgame was a great 3-hour movie. Irishman was not a great 3-hour movie. Irishman should have been dissected into 5 45-minute episodes or something like that. It should not have been a full fucking movie. Like, in one sitting. But Scorsese's 90 years old. He's an old man. He needs to retire and let the young dudes do more superhero movies. Because his old man shit is trash. This old man movies, he making this garbage, bro. Silence was trash. And so was The Irishman. I didn't even see Hugo. Fucking kids movie. So yeah, Scorsese could suck a dick. Alejandro Gonzalez and Narito could suck a dick. Ridley Scott could suck a dick. Bill Maher could suck a dick. Denis Villeneuve, if he says something about superhero movies or not, he could also suck a dick. Because Dune was trash. I'll diss him. He's not going to hire me. He doesn't hire black people. And I'm not an actor. So I can diss motherfuckers that ain't got nothing to do with me. Openly, willingly, I can diss the fuck out of directors that ain't got nothing to do with me. Oh, yeah. Also, in this episode, I ate a cookie. I was eating a cookie. I bought a cookie from a restaurant. A delicious cookie, might I add. A very delicious cookie. I talk about how I let it sit in my back pocket. And I let my body warm it up. You ever let your body warm up some food? Just put it in your back pocket and let it get warm and moist. So then when it's finally done cooking in your back pocket, you can just eat it. And it's chewy and nice and delicious and sweet. You ever do that? I did that. Oatmeal raisin. It's nothing but sugar. You shouldn't be eating that much sugar. But I'm a grown man and I exercise. So I can do what I want to do. If I want to eat a cookie, I'm going to eat a cookie. I'm going to just walk it off, do some jumping jacks and whatnot, you know? Do like 25 jumping jacks, take a 10-second break, another 25, just getting it. Hardcore getting it. Stay hard. Stay hard. David Goggins style. Stay hard. David Goggins is hilarious. I like David Goggins, and like this has nothing to do with his work ethic or his exercise or his like trials and tribulation. You can tell from his attitude, he ain't fucking no black women. This nigga is not fucking... He is so tense. Like, nigga, you need some black pussy. You are not fornicating with a black vagina. He definitely got a Caucasian wife. He only messed with Caucasian women, you could tell. And also, ain't no Nubian woman gonna deal with that shit. Why you running every day? Like, you trying to run away from me? Like, yeah. So I get it. Yeah. Get in where you fit in. That's the whole point. Get in where you fit in. You gotta get in where you fit in. A lot of people try to get in where they don't fit in. If you're a short guy, you know, why you trying to go to the NBA? Earl Boykin, Spud Webb, Nate Robinson. That's it. And Nate Robinson's 5'9", so he's like the tall of the shorts. He's not that short. Got to get in where you fit in. Make wise decisions. Don't be too stupid, you know? You got to make wise decisions and not be too stupid. I know I'm 5'7", and I do comedy. I'm not trying to dunk on nobody. I thought I was going to be able to dunk when I was little. I said, I'm probably going to be 6'3". Nah, still 5'7". I'm cool with it. Because I'm not going to the NBA. I'd hate to be 6'9" working at Dunkin' Donuts. Nothing wrong with working at Dunkin' Donuts, but if you're 6'9" working there, it's like, yo, you were destined to do other things, but you didn't do it. Hey, man, it's hard. You pick niggas for that. Shout out to LeVar Ball, big baller brand. Got a whole league putting money in kids' pockets. Entrepreneurship is very dope. It's super dope, man. Also, mental wealth, mental health. That's all good. Reading books is probably for mental wealth. And mental health is probably like meditation and whatnot. And physical health, too. Always be physically good. Chop the weight off. Chop the weight off if you can. Not all of it, but chop off what you can. Like Adele lost weight and she looks amazing. She still sang. She looks great. She looked good when she was thick, but she looked good now, too. She looked better now. She looks better now. I watched a little bit of her thing with the lady that don't like black people. They wanted to try to take down Michael Jackson after he died. That lady, the big girl. You get a car! Oh! I ain't gonna say her name. Stedman's girl. Yep. Stedman's woman. They're not even married. It's crazy. She ain't getting no money up for nothing. She ain't giving none of that money up. Make sure you hit him with the prenup. Was that back to back? Drake back to back. Make sure you hit him with the prenup. Yeah. Episode 38 is going good. I ate some cookies yesterday. The name of the episode is Cookies Are Delicious. Cookies are delicious. Because they are. Cookies are delicious. It's my favorite, like, fat boy snack. I don't eat donuts. I've eaten a donut this year, but I don't eat donuts, like, often. Like, I tried two or three of them. I ate a mini junk and two big ones. Just because, you know, donuts ain't that bad. I don't really go crazy when it comes to junk food. I eat it, but I don't go crazy with it. But I eat junk food. Definitely eat junk food. Like, if something's going to kill me, hopefully it's something that's delicious. Not cancer. Like, people smoke cigarettes because they like cigarettes, and the cigarettes killing them. They drink a lot of alcohol. Alcohol damages your liver and your skin, so it ends up killing you. I don't drink. I don't smoke. I try to sleep at least 6 hours a night, at the least. And also, I eat junk food. But I eat vegetables, too. I balance it out. But something's going to kill you in this world, so you got to pick your poison. My poison is junk food. Not a lot of it, though. Like, I eat unsalted nuts, unsalted dry roasted peanuts. I eat cheesy snacks to crunch. I eat salty potato snacks to crunch. I eat cream that is icy. I'm not really a big unhealthy guy. I take vitamins, sleep, vegetables. I took a piss in a bottle that I also spit in, flushed it out. Brushed my teeth, spitting it again. And then I forgot what else I added to it. But I opened it up to spit into it. And I was like, yo, this smells like an anus. Why does it smell like an anus? I did not defecate in this. Why does it smell like that? So I threw the bottle away. But when I'm done eating all of these, I got a new bottle. That's the circle of life. Don't sue me, Disney. I know y'all winning all y'all stuff. Y'all be suing people. Silk Sonic's album was dope. They got a song on there called 777 about gambling addiction. It's a pretty dope song. I thought somebody was knocking on my door. It's a pretty dope song. If you sell cocaine, this is your time, because Silk Sonic's album is out, and that is a cocaine-fueled album. Like, if you want to dabble in the cocaina, listen to that album while you're doing it. You're going to be... Whew, I need somebody as fly as me. 777. Woo. Smoking out the window. Hey. Hey, hey, hey. I forgot the names of all the songs. I'll be studying. I just listen. I don't study music. I just listen to it. A lot of people study music. Just listen. Like, one of my favorite artists is Gorillaz. I know, like, 10 songs, maybe. I don't study the whole track record. I don't study the album. I just listen to what I like. I'm a fan of Joyner Lucas. Still haven't heard ADHD or the album after that with the tattoos on the cover. There's a lot of artists I mess with, but I don't listen to all this stuff. You know? I listen to all the Kanye, all the Cudi, all the Tyler, except for Cherry Bomb, all the Eminem, except for the Revival and Marshall Mathers LP 2. But I'm a fan of what I'm a fan of, yeah? When it comes to music, I listen to whatever I want to listen to. And I take it easy. Take it easy. I don't go crazy with it. I don't be just going psychotic with it, listening to shit like, oh, I gotta get the new album, the new mixtape, the new album. I wait a week. Like, I know the redhead dude just put out the Equals album. I'm gonna listen to it in December. I'll take my time. I listen to what I want to listen to it. I didn't like the vibe that much, like four good songs on there. Plus in Multiply, flawless. Two good albums. The collaboration project is alright. It's alright. It's better than Divide. Now you got Equals. I'm going to bump Equals. I'm going to see what it's like. I'm going to listen to his interview on The Breakfast Club first. Then I'm going to go back and I'm going to mess with Equals. But for right now, I'm about to get these hash browns out of the oven so I can eat and then go outside and tell some jokes on this lovely November 18th, 2021 at 1:15 p.m. Get it. That's what I'ma do. That's what I'ma do. Like Beetlejuice. That's what I'ma do. Beetlejuice. Yeah, man. You feel me? Oh, a new episode of my show is out. Let me go ahead and download that because I don't watch ads. Yeah, you know me. I'm not watching no advertising. That is not my style, son. Watching ads? Are you serious?
Nigga, is you for real? You think I'm gonna watch an advertisement? You must have lost your mind, boy. I am not here to watch ads. I'm here to have fun and enjoy life. You think I'm about to watch an advertisement? You must be tripping.
I don't watch commercials. I don't watch commercials, but I know for a fact the baddest bitches on TV are in the Liberty Mutual commercials. And I ain't talking about the emu. I'm talking about the women. They don't hire a lot of ugly women for commercials. They hire mainly attractive women for commercials. And it is what it is. Ozark season 4 trailer just dropped. The teaser just dropped. You know what? I'm going to take a big solid dump. Then I'm going to come back and eat this food. But for right now, while I'm talking to you lovely folks, I got, let me see what I got here. I got 15 minutes of me speaking and 8 minutes of me speaking. Let's see. That's 23 minutes plus another 15. So that's 38 minutes. That's enough podcast for you guys. 38. Yeah, it's enough. 38's enough. I talked about nothing. I ate a cookie on the sidewalk. I spoke to you all for about 16 minutes. Yeah, I'm so bad at math. Let me get this right. 8. Oh, it's 9 minutes actually, because it's 8 minutes 58 seconds. So it's 9 minutes plus 15. So that's 24. 24 plus 10. That's 34. Plus 5. That's 39. I'll talk for one more minute and give you 40, all right? What should I do for the next one more minute and give you 40? You deserve a 40, all 5 of my listeners. You deserve a 40. Lil Nas X Maury show was hilarious. I learned about Solstice East, mistreating women. I'm not even going to talk about any of these things. I got to look up what the triangle shirt waist was. Jim Norton, Sick of Women. That's a classical old video I like laughing at. I gotta get this food out of the oven, but I don't want to forget nothing. I don't want to walk away and forget stuff. New episode of Something's Out. What's the podcast I like listening to? Oh, this is gonna kill me. Hold on. This is gonna hurt me, bro. I just wanna ride my bike. Slater. Don't get sued. Don't sue me. Hey, leave me alone, booby. Let me see. Godfrey did not steal my joke. What makes Red notice the next big heist movie? Oh, body cam shows suspect ramming into patrol cars before police shooting. Rest in peace, Young Dolph. Got a new movie coming out. This thing, that thing. You know what? Leroy Furicast, episode 38. That's my time. Enjoy the rest of the episode if you can hear it. If you can't, it's okay. You got 18 minutes for free. All right? Take care now. Bye-bye then. Leroy Furious. Leroy Furious out. Leroy Furycast, episode 38, continues. Cookies are delicious. Service vans. Or secret service trucks, whatever you call them. Hold on. Are my cookies done yet? Let me check on my cookies again. I got to check on my cookies. Alright, oh, they feel soft and broken. They feel soft and broken. Okay, Vin Diesel. Oh, here we go. Good ass cookie. This is my kind of vibe. Walking around, talking to all 5 of you lovely people, snacking on some good cookies. Oh my god. They're not moist, but they're sweet. Not moist, but very sweet. How I like it. It's delicious. Not at all nutritious. But it's still good for you. All right? When you're living this life, you got to know what's good for you. You can't be out here on mumbo jumbo time not knowing what's good for you. I'm outside, so you know I'm doing comedy. The Spider-Man trailer was dope. We all want to see Toby. We all want to see Andrew. They didn't show him in the trailer. But we got Electro. We got Max. We got Jamie Foxx with a good hairline. We got Lizard. We got Sandman. I know Venom's coming.
We already know Venom's coming, because if you saw the end of Venom, he licked the screen. He licked the screen during the multiverse poof when Doctor Strange was doing the spell to make everyone forget that Peter Parker was Spider-Man. The trailer tells so much. The trailer tells so much, dude. That's dope.
It tells a lot, but not too much. It tells so much and not a lot simultaneously. Marvel, John Watts, trailer editors, good job to everybody. You really know what you're doing, all right? All parties involved are killing it. Everybody's crushing it. I'm proud of you nerds. Also, John Watts is gonna direct the Fantastic Four movie. I hope it's the Fantastic Four from the 60s. Like in the comic books and in the podcast, they're from the 60s. Oh my God. This cookie is the truth, son. Hold on, what did it say? Do the what? So I can go see a bunch of artists perform that I don't want to see perform? Why would I do that to my body so I can see any of these people perform? Like, who cares about any of these individuals? I literally care about zero of these individuals on this little like tour date thing. I don't want to see any of these people. I'm not doing anything to my body that I don't want to do to go to a show to see people who I don't want to see. Why would I do that? That's the dumbest thing in the world. If I don't care, why would I do it? I'm speaking in codes, but you know what I mean. Eyaba, eyaba, eyaba. Why would I get eyaba to do some stuff I don't want to do? That's stupid. That's dumb. I do like working out, though. I've been working out a lot recently. Not like The Rock, just like a regular person. Richard Simmons. Richard Simmons is a dope guy. Richard Simmons is a dope, personal trainer, workout guy. Regular body, very obtainable. Attainable? I don't know. But he's a dope guy. Shout out to Richard Simmons. That's a good workout guy to follow. Not too ripped, not too buff, not muscular. Just a regular body. Keep your body moving. Burn the calories off. Have fun. Have an afro. And get money in the process. That's all he does. Now me, I don't believe that I'm money motivated simply because I have zero money coming in. But I'm good. I'm cheap as hell. I'm eating a cookie and doing a podcast to 5 people. That's my life. At 28 years old, that's my life. And I like it like that. You know what I could be? I could be a turd nugget sitting in the sewer eating rats, doing drugs. But I know I'm better than that. That's why I ain't doing it. Got a quarter of a minute. Hold on. No, I said a quarter of a minute. That's 15. I got 20 seconds to cross the street right now. 20 seconds across the street. These cars are driving by. They're blazing. They're blazing fast. Let me hurry up before this guy puts a vehicle in my butt. All right. He's in a rush. He's in a rush. I got 4 seconds to cross and he drove in front of me anyway. Okay. Good thing my eyes are open. Good thing I know where I'm going. Good thing I'm not a turd nugget like him. Know what I'm saying? I'm excited right now. I'm about to go to a quiet neighborhood and record some of this in the quiet neighborhood. It's so quiet, I might have to lower my voice. But no, seriously. Fuck that dude who drove in front of me. Fuck him. Gloriously fuck him. The fucking dickhead. He didn't almost hit me though. He knew what he was doing. I saw him coming. He's a turd nugget. He could have waited. I'm not gonna tell this joke again. It's a joke I tell dealing with a rap group where the leader is from South Jamaica, Queens.
Oh, God. Oh, here we go. Mm. I got like one bite left. I'm done with this cookie. It's so good, I'm telling you. It's so delicious. Bro. Mmm. Hold on. Oh. Oh. Never litter. When you get done eating your garbage food, throw it in the trash, don't litter. You know you live in a really bad neighborhood if it's litter all over the ground and the trash can is empty. Move. Move. If there's trash all over the ground and the trash, if there's litter on the ground and the trash can is empty, move out of the neighborhood. Leave immediately, as soon as possible. Get out of there. I'm so serious. Get out of there. Things are dangerous. Things are looking bad. You gotta get out of there, bro. You have to get out of there. Stop staying around. It's not gonna be any good for you. You gotta get out. And I'm serious, too. You gotta get out. I don't understand littering. Like, just put the trash in your pocket or wait until you find a trash can. Find a dumpster. Be patient. You don't gotta get rid of the trash immediately. Just wait a little while. Now, I'm not a big advocate for like Mother Earth or like nature or the ecosystem. I'm just saying, don't be a fucking filthy animal. Like, wait until you get, like, wait till you get the trash somewhere where it's supposed to go. By the way, speaking of filthy animals, I watched the new Home Alone. Whoever wrote the new Home Alone needs to go to fucking prison. Mikey Day, I'm sorry. Mikey Day, you need to go to prison for that. That movie was so atrocious. First off, they fucked it up. The writing was so bad. Why would you make the kid so much of an asshole, even though the two people that broke into the house were in the right completely? They were in the right, and the kid didn't know. So they basically were trying to get something that was theirs back. And the kid didn't know, so he made a mistake by pranking them. And then it was revealed that what they wanted wasn't in the house at all the whole time. It was just stupid. It was just a dumb, like, they fucked it up by writing it. Ellie Kemper and Rob Delaney weren't horrible in it, but the writing was atrocious. The little kid that put the Nazi in Jojo Rabbit, the Nazi from Jojo Rabbit was good as a Nazi. In this movie, they fucked them all up. They fucked them all up. The shit was horrendous. They fucked the whole thing up. And that's how it was. They fucked the whole thing up. The writers need to go to prison for like 6 months. They need to get the ribs worked on. It was so bad. Like, the story, like, it wasn't funny. The kid was just an asshole for no reason. Like, it was like, it's such a bad movie. Like, and they made, that's Home Alone 6. I saw the first four. I'm not watching the fifth because why would I do that to myself? I'm mad I watched four when I was little. Four came on TV when I was little, and I watched the whole thing. I fucked up. But I was a kid. You can't blame me. And then this one came out, Home Alone 6, and I'm like, why am I watching this one? This is dumb too. But I watched it anyway because it didn't cost me nothing. It didn't cost me much. It's on a streaming service, a free streaming service. I mean, it's on a streaming service, but you ain't got to pay for it. If you pay for the streaming service, you already get it. You don't got to pay extra, like a premiere access. And I was like, yo, this movie is horrendous, and the writing is atrocious. The story's fucked up. The cinematography's fucked up. The crude humor's fucked up. I'm like, who in their right mind will watch this movie and laugh at this family while they get... Who would watch this movie and laugh at the two people that are intruding the home while they're getting fucked up by pranks? Like, why would you laugh at this shit? It's bullshit. It's fucking dumb. They fucked up the way they wrote it. It's all garbage and malarkey. I didn't like the way they did it. Like, why would I laugh at this? It's not funny. The first two, they're funny because they're assholes trying to get into a house. And then part two, they're trying to kill a kid. Like, that's why it's a fucking, like, that's why the first two are dope. The first two are really dope movies. Third one, I just liked it because it was four people instead of two. The fourth one, I kind of blocked it out of my mind because it was so bad. And it was on TV. Fifth one, I don't know why they made that. It wasn't a cash grab, but no one even paid to see that bullshit. And this one, I don't know what it was for. I think someone's just trying to hire somebody. I think they were trying to cash in on Jojo Rabbit. They're trying to cash in on the fucking Jojo Rabbit movie. Like, yo, remember this movie from 2019? Well, 2 years later, we got the Fat Kid, and this is what it is. And it's like, this is the bullshit y'all giving us? This is the bullshit? I'm supposed to like this bullshit? I don't like it. I'm not gonna like it. Because it's bullshit. And you know how bad the movie is? I'm shitting on it on my podcast. If I'm shitting on a movie on my podcast, you know it's bad. Because I never shit on movies, ever. I never shit on movies. If a movie sucks, it sucks. I let it suck on its own. I'm not gonna shit on it. But this fucking Home Alone 6 is fucking hot garbage. Whoever wrote Home Alone 6 needs to go to fucking prison for 6 months and get their ribs worked on. That's how fucking bad it is. Speaking of bad, I'm like a borderline homeless person. Not really. I'm practicing homeless. And the fucking, I'm on the train one time. I'm on the train. Oh, this shit too loud. I'm on the train, and this fucking dude gets on the train as well, sits across from me and says, "Hey, you smell good." I'm like, hold up, slow your roll, partner. I don't roll that way, and you ain't got no game. You know why you ain't got no game? Because I don't fucking smell good. I'm borderline homeless. I'm not a smelling good person. I don't smell good. I haven't smelled good since 2010. I smelled good like 11 years ago. You telling me I smell good? You fucking lying. You got no game. Get out of my face. I don't roll like that. And then he tried to get in like an argument with me and shit, like an argument. Talking about some old, yes, you do smell good. How you gonna tell me you don't smell good? You smell good. I'm like, it ain't fucking me. I don't fucking smell good. I didn't say that. I was just like, yes. I just kept shaking my head. No. But you know who did smell good? A woman. There was a woman on the train that smelled amazing. First off, the dude that was telling me I smell good, he ain't had no fucking mask on. So like, why you got no fucking mask on, bro? You breaking protocol. You gotta follow proto, bro. You got no fucking mask on. Like, what the fuck am I gonna, like, accept your compliment when you out here being a super spreader? You a motherfucking disease boy. Fuck out of my face, disease boy. I don't play that shit. Nasty ass. Fuck you talking about? If a woman with no mask on said it, I'd be like, oh, that's cool. That's cool. I'm cool with that, you know? She ain't got no mask on. She a little rowdy. She a little dirty. I can get down with that. I must not look homeless enough. This dude just asking for a dollar. I must not look homeless enough. I have a plastic bag in my hand, and I'm carrying around a broken Android phone, speaking into it like a homeless person, and the guy still proceeded to ask me for a spare change. Do I not look homeless enough? Do I look clean? Do I look like I have it all together? I'm fucking unemployed, and this still grown-ass man asked me for money. I thought this would work. I thought I had the key code. I thought I had the code to life. I thought I had Pandora's box unlocked. Apparently I don't. Apparently there's still people that think I'm doing good in life. I'm fucking unemployed. I don't have any money. I have $0 at all. Why they want this? Why? What are they doing? I walk past another guy that's asking for money. I don't have $0. I have 15. I got like 15. That's enough. But I'm dodging, I'm ducking. That's how it goes. All right. Something smells great. Oh, you know what smells good? Manure. Maybe the guy thought I smelled like shit and said, hey, you smell good. But there was a woman on the train that smelled good, so I'm thinking he was smelling the woman, but he can't talk to girls, so he came to me. And I said, no, I do not smell good. I fucking stink. Leave me alone. I stink. Stay away from me. My foot did not fall asleep this time. Episode 38. That's what this is. Episode 38 of the Leroy Furicast. I'm gonna get to a quiet part and talk a little more. Be back. Be right back. Wait until I got over here where it's peaceful and quiet. Like pure peace and quiet. Like not a horn, not an engine brewing, not a motor or nothing. It's like 1,000 cabs out here trying to get a ride from a train station. Like, yo, why don't y'all just join a rideshare app? Like this cab shit is wild. Like it's like 100 cabs out here. Just trying to get one person at a time to one place. They just lined up like a weird factory. Totally just get a fucking rideshare app. Like, I never will catch a cab. I heard about how they treat black people. They don't pick us up. That's why I only mess with ride sharing apps. One in particular, the kind that gets you off the ground to another place. It picks you up, Yeah, the other one that's like a joke from the Kumail Nanjiani movie, yeah, they banned me, so I'm only messing with the one that scoops you up and gets you where you gotta go. That's the only one I mess with. Now, if I could invest in that company, I most definitely would. I should find out how. I should find out how to put some dough in it and let it grow with it. You know what I mean? Dough with it, grow with it. This building looks like a perfect building that The Rock would jump out of and land on his shoulder and live in one of them Hollywood movies that he's in with the stunt double and all of that, you know? It looks like one of those kind of buildings. Scooter Brothers, Trevor Phillips. Shout out to Lamar. Lamar. Not Lamar from GTA, Lamar from BMF. Good character. Super evil. He has to make it to the second season. If he dies in season one, it's a dumb show from that point on. There's no villain that could replace him. And it just hit me. He's 35 years old, and he's beefing with a 16-year-old and a 17-year-old duo of brother drug dealers. Like, brother drug dealers, and he's beefing with them. That's the dumbest thing in the world. You're a grown man. And y'all smashing the same chick? Hold on. I think Cash Doll's playing a pedophile. I think Cash Doll's playing a lady pedo messing with a high school student, or a high school dropout, who is Meech. But Meech might be, he might be a, like a, not emancipated, he might be a, like 18-year-old who's just dropped out. He could be, or the legal age of consent in Detroit, Michigan, or Michigan, the state, might be like 16 or something. That's why he's doing what he's doing with her. Or it could be illegal and she's a criminal too. You know, she's a criminal, he's a criminal. They're all criminals, breaking the law side by side, just trying to get by. But Cash Doll, I never knew who she was. Like, I heard the name before. I know there's an Asian doll and a Cash Doll. An Asian doll, black. She's black. I don't know why it says Asian. She probably got a little bit of Filipino in her. I noticed that a lot of people that's mixed, black and Asian, they put on for the Asian side way harder. Like, she could have called herself Black Doll, Ethiopian Doll, but she said, nope, Asian Doll. African Doll, nope, Asian Doll. And you look at her, she doesn't look very Asian to me. Like, I don't think Asian people will claim her. I don't think Asian people claim black Asians. Like, I heard the dude, I heard a straight up like Asian dude. When I say Asian, I mean like Korean, Japanese. Korean, Japanese, Chinese, probably Vietnamese. Asian dude, straight up say he doesn't claim Kumail Nanjiani is Asian. He said, I don't think Kumail Nanjiani is one of us. Cause he's darker, that's it. That's what I'm saying that. He said he doesn't claim Kumail Nanjiani is Asian. I'm saying it's because he's darker. That's why. Because, let's be honest, people be racist. And it's a fact. People be racist. Racist against me, kind of hard to get. It's kind of hard to be racist against me because I don't really go to other groups. I kind of stick with my own people. It's kind of hard to, it's kind of hard to experience racism hardcore if you stick with your own people. Like the Sopranos, they're Italians. They only mess with other Italians. That's me. I only mess with other melanated people. If you ain't melanated and I'm around you, it's because I like the environment of the thing. Like when I do comedy, it's a lot of ethnicities. And I'm not there to kick you with the ethnicities. I'm there to tell jokes. If they're there and they cool with me and I'm cool with them, then everybody cool. But I don't go to other groups looking for validation. I validate myself. What does validate mean? I have no clue. I'm talking to an android, not a defibrillator, continuum transfunctioner, not a scientist. I'm a regular average Joe, law-abiding citizen. What's today's date? The Spider-Man trailer dropped yesterday. Today is the 17th. I think today is November 17th. Yeah, November 17th, because in 1 month it'll be December 17th, and then Spider-Man No Way Home will be out for all to enjoy and all to watch. I heard Ridley Scott old ass talking some shit. Ridley Scott old bitch ass put out that boring ass Last Duel movie that nobody saw, talking shit on superhero movies. Hey, don't worry about superhero movies. Ridley Scott, Martin Scorsese, Denis Villeneuve, which is a shitty ass Dune movie. Who else is a fucking bumfuck who's talking shit? Alejandro Gonzalez Inarritu. Hey, Alejandro Gonzalez Inarritu. You're fucking Mexican and you make movies with no Mexicans in them. You don't even fuck with your own people. Shut up, you fucking Mexicoon. You're a fucking coon. Ridley Scott don't fuck with niggas, so fuck Ridley Scott. Marvel and DC, they fuck with way more black people than you do. So fuck you, Ridley Scott. Martin Scorsese talking shit, talking about, it's like a roller coaster. It's boring. No, it's not. It's like a roller coaster. Guess what? Roller coasters are way more fun than the Irishman. So fuck Martin Scorsese as well. Fuck Martin Scorsese. Fuck Ridley Scott. Fuck Denis Villeneuve. Fuck Alejandro Gonzalez Iñárritu. Fuck Uwe Boll. Fuck all of those boring ass directors that shit on superhero movies. Because superhero movies employ way more melanated people than you motherfuckers do. They employ way more melanated people. So Ridley Scott can suck a big fat dick. Denis Villeneuve can suck a big fat dick. Martin Scorsese can suck a big fat dick. all these directors can suck a big fat dick. If you shit on superhero movies, suck a big fat dick. Alright? If you shit on superhero movies and you doing bullshit movies yourself, suck a big fat dick. All of y'all. Don't ever disrespect motherfucking superhero movies, alright? Most superhero movies are better than your whole fucking catalog. Guardians of the Galaxy is better than Martin Scorsese's whole catalog. And I love The Departed, but it ain't fucking with Guardians of the Galaxy. Denis Villeneuve, shut your boring ass up. You got Sicario, that's it. Sicario and Blade Runner 2049, which is a fucking sequel to some old shit, because you're not fucking original enough to make your own shit up, so you're doing sequels to old shit. You could have made a new original thing, but you didn't. And you remade Dune, you remade a David Lynch movie. You're remaking shit. You make a remake and a sequel. You make remakes and sequels. Arrival was boring as fuck. Denis Villeneuve, I don't know if you talk to us, I don't know if he talks shit about superhero movies per se, but if he did, he could suck a big fat French dick. I'm American, so you ain't gonna be mad. All y'all motherfuckers that talk shit about superhero movies can suck a big fat dick. Unless your shit is good and rivals it, you can't talk shit. You know who can talk shit about superhero movies? You know who can talk shit about superhero movies and I'll be okay with it? S. Craig Zahler or Jordan Peele. Because they got Brawl on Cell Block 99, Dragged Across Concrete, and Get Out. Those are three dope-ass movies by two dope-ass directors, all right? If they want to talk shit about superhero movies, they can. Anybody else? Suck a big fat dick. Quentin Tarantino? He can talk shit because he got good fucking movies. If you're not Tarantino, if you're not Gareth Edwards or Evans, if you didn't direct The Raid, if you're not Quentin Tarantino, Jordan Peele, or S. Craig Zahler, shut the fuck up, all right? Because The Suicide Squad is the best movie I've seen all year. I watched The Suicide Squad, 9-10 times. I watched The Irishman once and regretted it. I never want to go back to that bullshit. That movie was fucking dumb. I'm never watching fucking Last Duel again. I saw half of it and said, I missed the whole first hour and I didn't miss anything. If I can miss the whole first hour of your movie and not miss anything, you gotta cut the fat. You need to cut some fucking fat. Cut some fat off your shitty fucking movie. All right, Ridley Scott, cut some fucking fat off your shitty fucking movie. And this has been Leroy Furicast, episode 38. Peace out.
Bro, this guy's been married for 10 years, and you're just like, when did you get married when you were 10? Jesus Christ. And give it up for your next comic. He's very funny. He's probably got stuff. Give it up for Leroy Furious, everyone.
What's up? What's up? Britney Spears is free. Who's next? Ben Meach or Larry Hoover? I had a prostitute come to my house last week. She sat on my bed and I said, okay, how do we start? And she said, we could just talk, you know? And I was like, if I knew how to talk to women, you wouldn't be here, so. It's gonna be vaginal or oral? Like, I gave her oral sex. I gotta apologize for my attire. I apologize for how I'm dressed right now. My shoes are kind of dirty. I was at the Travis Scott Festival last weekend. It's kind of hard to get these stains out, man. Like, they played sicko mode. I went crazy, you know? Drake came out. You know how hard it is to get Gen Z teeth out of your laces? I got a canine right here. All right, whatever. A canine is a sharp, it's a vampire tooth. I'm unemployed, so I'm trying to become a dentist right now. It's kind of hard becoming a dentist. You got to study and shit. So right now, I got like a little part-time job. It's freelance work. I'm just pickpocketing people. Pickpocketing people is very profitable. I don't know if you noticed or not. I bumped into like 10 people on my way here, and I got 2 months rent already. Yeah, it's not hard to pickpocket people. Everyone's on their phones now. No one's looking around and shit. Like, I pick and choose all my victims very carefully. Like, I saw this old lady on the train. She was giving me Jim Crow vibes. She was giving me, like, Jim Crow 1720 vibes, you know? So I took her watch. It's nice and shiny. Don't worry about it. I won't take y'all shit. And she was sitting beside her husband, so I got his watch as well. And, like, I was watching The Sopranos. And I'm like, yo, this is a good-ass show, but Italians don't really fuck with black people that much. So I had to go all the way to New Jersey to tell some jokes. I went to New Jersey to tell some jokes, and I bumped into an elderly Italian man, and I got his watch as well. He could have chased me down and took the watch back, but I don't think he had the makings of a varsity athlete.
Oh.
I know y'all smoke weed. I ain't got to ask. I know y'all smoke weed, and I bumped into y'all as well. Sir, I apologize. I think I have your lighter right here. Ma'am, I have your lighter as well. I'm sorry about that. Sir, I think I have your lighter as well. Hold on. Yeah, my fault. I got somebody else's lighter. I don't know who this is. I just take whatever I want, you know. I went to the FBI building. I was like, yo, these feds be cracking down on black people too hard, you know. I bumped into this FBI agent and I got his handcuffs as well. ASMR. It's cuffing season. Oh. Whatever. What y'all want to talk about? Israel and Palestine? Y'all want to talk about Israel and Palestine? That's what y'all want to talk about? I don't watch the news, so I don't know much about it. There's not really a can of worms I want to open. Israel and Palestine. But if I did want to open that can of worms, I could, because like 2 hours ago, I was at Sears and I stole a can opener. It's stainless steel with a black plastic grip. It's dope. Love this shit. You see how fast I am pulling shit out of my pockets? I would have fucked Alec Baldwin up. My father-in-law hates me because I stole his daughter. And I stole his class ring. All right, that's it. No more shit I stole. What's something else? Who wrote the movie Shrek? Like, who said, all right, I got a kid's movie where a donkey fucks a dragon? All right. A lot of women have preferences when it comes to dating. They have preferences. They prefer to date men that are not my height. I'm not mad at it. I'm cool with it. I just find it funny how, like, a guy my height will be, like, considered too short to date. But if you see me in the alley with a black hoodie on and I go, give me your purse, they be like, oh no, it's a big scary black man. Oh, bitch, I'm big now, huh? Right. When I first started doing comedy, two dudes accused me of stealing a joke. I never stole their joke. I would never steal your joke. It was like my fifth time on stage. And he said, hey, Leroy, that one joke you told, you stole it from the guy going on after me. Oh, I was like, I can't tell the future, son. Like, come on. I never stole their jokes, but I did put on a black hoodie and I saw them in the alley and I got both of their Samsung phones. Hey, that's my time, thank you.
Give it a Leroy Free and Furious, everybody. Told you he's got stuff. He had stuff. He has things that are probably yours.
This is my podcast. This is my podcast. Leroy Furious, the Leroy Furicast. This is my podcast. This is my podcast. This is my, I say what the fuck I want, bitch.